Good evening, hello, and welcome to Gloucester Cathedral for tonight's organ recital given on this sensational instrument in this infamous acoustic. Jonathan Hope is going to give us a truly wonderful program tonight of Bach, a new transcription of a piece by Elgar, and a complete organ symphony by Louis Vierne. These videos are supported entirely by you. If you're able to support these recitals, links are on the screen. So, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome to tonight's Organ Loft, Jonathan Hope.
Thank you. Hello and welcome to the Organ Loft at Gloucester Cathedral. I'm Jonathan Hope, the Assistant Director of Music, and I suppose the best way to describe my job is if you come to a service at Gloucester Cathedral and you hear a lot of noise coming from the organ loft, it's probably me. And I'm delighted that Richard has asked me to make this film, play you this virtual recital, and I hope you enjoy listening to the organ and seeing all the different shots of the cathedral and the organ, and listen to the wonderful acoustic as well. What you've just heard is the Prelude and Fugue in G major by J.S. Bach, and it's quite an early Bach piece, around 1710, 1715, very much in the style of the Stilus Fantasticus style of Buxtehude, definitely inspired by that. And so I really hope you enjoyed that real Bach toe tapper. What I'm going to play to you now is something that was a lockdown project of mine. In the first lockdown, I started transcribing some more pieces, and having transcribed another of Elgar's overtures in the south, I thought I'd do one of the others, and Froissart, which was Elgar's first overture, came to mind. And this was a piece that was premiered at the 1890 Three Choirs Festival in Worcester. And being 2020, it was 130 years since that piece was composed, and I thought it would be a good one to do. I think you'll find that it's very conducive to being played on the organ. It lies under the fingers very nicely, and it allows us to explore some of the lovely fluty colours on the organ, as well as the big bombastic full sound of the organ. So I hope you enjoy Elgar's Froissart overture. Thank you. Elgar's wonderful Froissart Overture. I hope you enjoyed that. We're going to head over the channel now, and pretty much a contemporary of Elgar's, a little bit younger than Elgar, was Louis Vierne over in Paris. And Vierne started off being Charles-Marie Vidor's assistant at Saint-Sulpice, where there's a wonderful Cavaille-Cole organ. And he eventually moved on from there and became organist titulaire at Notre Dame Cathedral. And his six symphonies are quite autobiographical in that you can see in the first symphony he's trying to find his way a bit and explore writing symphonies. And symphony number one was the one he wrote while he was at Saint-Sulpice. I'm going to play you number two, symphony number two. And it's the first one he wrote at Notre Dame. And as Vierne symphonies go on through three, four, five, and then six, they get gradually more adventurous, but also more tortured. Vierne had a very sad life. He gradually went blind by the end of his life. He was always very short-sighted, but then got more and more blind. He had a very unhappy marriage and ended up divorcing his wife, and also his brother and his son both lost their lives in the First World War. So he had a very sad life in many ways. And as the symphony, once you get to Symphony 4, it's very, very gloomy indeed. Symphony number 2, he's still quite young. He's a little younger than I am now, actually. And it's quite bold and it's quite confident. So he hasn't quite got to the depths of despair yet in this symphony. It's a very uplifting symphony. It's also a cyclic symphony. So the theme you hear at the beginning of the first movement, you will hear come back at the end of the fifth movement as well. So five movements, an Allegro maestoso at the beginning, a chorale in movement two, a little scherzo in the middle, a lovely cantabile as movement four, and then a very typically French finale at the end. So I hope you enjoy Vierne's second symphony.
Thank you.
That was Vierne's Second Symphony, and that brings to a close the recital. And I really hope you've enjoyed listening to the organ of Gloucester Cathedral and wallowed in the our wonderful 8-second acoustic. And I really hope you will share this video with others and really make the most of it. So it only remains for me to thank you for watching. Do keep an eye out for organ recitals and organ concerts and things that are happening here. We're always very welcoming and we'd love to see you. If you have a chance to come and hear me play La Nativité by Olivier Messiaen on Sunday the 12th of December at 6 p.m. We'd love to see you, and obviously more details about that are on the cathedral website, gloucestercathedral.org.uk. So without further ado, I'd just like to say goodbye and thanks for watching.
Hello, there's me.
Do a Briggs one take wonder. Epic.
Cool.
You happy with that take?
Yeah, I'm happy with that actually.
Good. It sounded good. It was very exciting.
Anything? I never get those right. So
I'm sure he didn't
get them close.
Not sure if he did.
Come see what I was doing anyway.
yeah. Exactly. Oh, someone's here. Hello.
I just want to say.
Oh, it's James.
Just me.
This is James, our number three.
Hello, number three, James.
Hi. Richard McVeigh.
Yes.
How you doing?
Well, I have actually watched some of your videos.
Have you?
Yes, I have enjoyed. Yes.
Oh, crud. Yeah.
This is acoustic. It's funny because it either hides your mistakes or it augments them.
Yeah.
Depending on what stop you're on.
Yeah. Yeah. What it feels like.
And if you're a trumpet, like I've done in hymns sometimes. Yeah.
Leave it on the page turner.
Yeah.
Delighted to be giving you an organ that. Thank you.
jolly good.